I earn my clothes after I put them on. Right? After I put them on. You know, when I was young, you know, me and my wife were so close, so much endearment. She'd get up in the morning, she would heat the water for my coffee, she'd come in. Darling, the coffee's ready, the water's hot now. So after we lived together a little while, she'd come in the room, she'd say, your water's hot. That's about the only thing hot around here. You should sit on that stove. Maybe you get hot once in a while. The man came in the house, he had a sheep up under his arm. He walked in the house, and he walked in the bedroom where the wife was lying down in the bed. He said, look what I gotta make love to. He said, oh no, you make love to a sheep. He said, shut up, woman, I'm not talking to you. Have you ever went to the supermarket and went back to the meat counter? There's always somebody back at the meat counter, you know, you're waiting on them, but you can't get around them. They're standing there like that, you know. And they're saying, how much meat can I buy for $10? And I'm thinking to myself, your knees are already sagging. You need that to lighten up a little bit. You know what I mean? There was a man went to the doctor and he said, Doc, my wife, she just never want to have sex. I just don't know what to do. And the doctor said, I got just the thing. Jeff got these pills. When you get home, buy some wine, go home, put one pill in a drink. Be careful. These pills are very powerful, so you got to be ready. Thought about that. He said, okay, I better put two pills in my drink. So he bought the wine, he put two pills in his drink and one in hers. Now, sure enough, she was ready. Oh, man, oh, wow. I need a man right now, baby. He's over there going, I need a man too, baby. The man walked into the bar. He had a seeing eye dog, so he walked in the bar. He had the dog like this. As he got in the bar, he grabbed a dog by the tail, started swinging the dog around his head like that. And people said, wait a minute, what are you doing? Hold on, what are you doing? He said, I'm just taking a look around. Don't worry about nothing. I'm taking a look around. As I said earlier, me and my wife had a very, very good relationship for a while. But now I'm divorced, and I wanted her to let me get the alimony a little lower. It's killing me right now. So well, maybe I'll call her and find out if she let me, you know, kind of give me a break on the alimony. So I taped it, and this is what she said.
Well, you get the alimony, baby.
Well, that didn't work out. So anyway, it wasn't always like that. We had some very erotic nights, very romantic nights. I remember when I take one session that we had, we were very, very lovely, very erotic. So it's explicit. So be ready. So this is a very explicit. It didn't exactly sound like that at the time. I'm not sure how that went, but it just didn't sound like that at the time. But right now, I'd like to show you what happened when two brothers went to the employment office. These two brothers went to the employment office. So the first brother went up to the counter in the employment office the lady said, well, what can you do? You know, he said, I'm a seamstress. I sew. She said, well, what do you sew? He said, I sew panties. He said, okay, I'll start you off at 8:50 an hour. The other guy walked up to the counter, you know. She said, what do you do? He said, I'm a diesel fitter. She said, oh, that sounds important, a diesel fitter. Okay, I'll start you up at 17:50 an hour. So the seamstress said, you gonna start him up with 17:50 an hour and start me up at 8:50 an hour? She said, he has an important job. He worked with diesel. He said, yeah, he worked with diesel. I'm sewing these panties and I put them in this pile over there, and all he does is in diesel fitter, diesel fitter, diesel fitter. He said, all day long, he's putting those panties on his head and said, diesel fitter. Thank you very much.
Simmons, guys, that was awesome.